In this video, we will learn some of the advanced search operators in Google, which we can quickly use to narrow down our search. Because most of the time, we get a lot of results and it is impossible for us to use those. And by using these advanced operators, you should be able to focus and you should be able to narrow down your search. So the first advanced operator is file type. So let's say I am only looking for PDF files. So what I can do is in my Google search, I can type file type and then colon and then PDF without space PDF. And then I can type, for example, Word tutorials. And now Google will show me only this type of files. As you can see that all search results on the left hand side, they have PDF. So if you are interested only in one type of file, you can put it here. For example, if you are looking for PowerPoint presentations, just type PPT and then whatever is your search query or whatever is the keyword you want to type, you can do that and press enter. And now you will get only the PowerPoint files. So this is a file type operator. And there are few things you can do straight away in this Google search. For example, if you want to quickly calculate a percentage, 76% of, let's say, 976. So Google will immediately show you the answer. So simple calculation, you don't have to even open your calculator app. You can quickly type in Google and you can get the results. And as you can see, this is a scientific calculator. You can calculate some trigonometric functions here. You can calculate log, sine, cos, tan, exponential, and power as well. You can also solve triangles in Google. So if I type solve and then triangle, and let's say I put the wrong spelling of this and press enter. Now Google will spell check my phrase. It will correct the spelling and it will show me that it is showing the result for solved triangle, although the spelling I put were wrong. And now you can solve the triangle. And here you can find many things. For example, you can solve for area if you know the base and the height. As you can see here, if I put base, for example, 40, and I put height 10, my area will be 200. You can also solve this triangle for other parameters such as height, base, any side, if you know the angle, or for perimeter, etc. For each one of them, you will need a different value to enter. Let's say I want to solve it for a side A. I want to find the length of this side A. But now what I have to put here, the area of the triangle I should know, and the other side and the angle between these two sides. So if I know the area, if I know the adjacent side, and if I know the angle between these two, I can just put it here and I can get the value. So you can also solve a parallelogram. Here you can find the area by putting just the base and the height of this parallelogram. So these type of simple calculations and simple geometrical calculation you can do on Google straight away. Another powerful way to search in Google is to find something near your location. So near me is a very powerful phrase. You can find something food near me or gas near me. So these kind of things. So let's say I type food near me. Now Google will show me all the restaurants near my location. And if I click on any of these restaurants, and here we can see the rating of this restaurant. And if we go further down, we can even read the reviews of the customers. So this is another feature in Google. Another powerful feature is searching by exact phrase. So let's say we search free online courses. Now here we get 4.4 billion results. So these are not, of course, any use to us. So what we can do is we can just put quotation marks before and after this phrase. And now if we search, our search results are drastically reduced. And now if we want to reduce this further, we can put some advanced operator here. For example, intitle. It means that Google will now show us only those pages in which we have this as a title, part of the title. So if I enter now, we only have 78,200 results. So intitle is a powerful way to reduce the search, because now if something is in the title of the page, so it means that page will be more relevant to us. Now we can also use another operator, and is an operator. By default, and is always present here, but because I want to use two operators, intitle and inurl, and then colon, and then we have to put the same again. Now here I am using intitle, which is an advanced operator, inurl. Inurl means that this exact phrase should be in the URL of the web page, or the web address of the web page, and in the title as well. So now if I search, now I can reduce my results further to 10,300 only. So this is how you can use these advanced operators. There are few more things I would like to mention. For example, I want to search a video on YouTube about a PowerPoint tutorial which is more than 20 minutes long, and which is a maybe recent video within 1 month or so. So what I can do is, I can type my phrase first, PowerPoint tutorial, and now I can click on these videos. And once in the videos, now I have these tools icon, and if I click on tools, I will get these filters available. And here I can select my criteria. Let's say my duration is should be longer than 20 minutes. My time frame is then within past year, or I can select past month as well. Let's say past month. And then I can also select the quality of the video should be high. And now my search has reduced to only these videos. And now let's say I want to see only videos on the YouTube. Then I can use another operator, which is site colon youtube.com. Now it will only show me the videos which are available on the YouTube. As you can see, now all these videos are on the YouTube. So this is another powerful feature. You can select videos and you can apply filters. By default, we are in this all section, but here we can go into video section. Now at the end, let's search for images. So I am searching for space images, and then I want to search from NASA website, nasa.gov, and now I get these space images. If I click on images, now I can apply these tools. If I click on tools, now I have these filters available: the size of the image, what size I want, the color, the dominant color of the image, similarly the usage rights, also the type of the image. So all these filters are available, and in particular very important is the time. You can select any images within past month, for example. Let's see if we have any image past month. So these are images which are issued by NASA just 1 day ago, you can see here. So this is how you can use some advanced Google search operators to narrow down your search and to focus on a specific topic. So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.